Hello and welcome back to Truck World TV from our base here at Junction 38, T-Bay Services.
And now it's time for this week's road test, which comes courtesy of the DAF XF. Tim, as ever, has been down to Millbrook working very hard and has been putting it through its paces.
As everybody in the truck industry is well aware, we've recently undergone the change from Euro 5 to Euro 6 emissions. That's meant that the truck manufacturers have redesigned the chassis. They've also taken the opportunity to either redesign the cab or put a new cab on top. DAF has been one of the last to the market with this. They've redesigned the cab and they've redesigned the chassis. But is it a case of saving the best till last? One of the most striking trucks on the road today, the new XF has been cleverly designed to not only look good, but to also use clever aerodynamics to aid efficiency. The corner wing deflectors, for example, help to keep the door mirrors and handles clean. DAF and the design engineers are masters of the facelift. Why do I say that? Well, believe it or not, underneath this ultra-modern looking truck is a cab structure that's over 25 years old. But the power behind the new XF is a range of brand new Paccar MX units. The engine delivers 410 horsepower to 510 horsepower in the flagship model. So 510 horsepower, we're linked also to a 12-speed Acertronic gearbox. We're going up the hill here now, pulling about 1500 revs, and I'm going to drop it down to about 1000. And this engine is so torquey that we can actually pull the 40 tons we've got, 44 tons, and we're actually accelerating. And that tells you the sort of power that's behind this vehicle. As I said, we're around about just over the 500 horsepower, so they were just slightly more than the norm. UK, we're looking at 450 to 500 horsepower. This is slightly just over, but it makes a heck of a difference when you're going up the hill. We're going downhill now, and we've got the engine brake on. This thing is virtually pulling you backwards. Some of the competition that I've driven recently, we found out the fact that it doesn't, not really that effective, the engine braking system. Here on this DAF, I must admit, it's probably one of the best I've had. Going downhill, it looks like someone's actually put a parachute behind me and is pulling me backwards, and that's what you want. The least amount of time that you need to use a service brake means better reliability and also reduced cost. And it's costs that are all important for hauliers today. Yes, it's great that the truck looks good and makes your driver happy, but it also has to save you money at the pumps, so cutting edge technologies and clever aerodynamics that can save points of a gallon are essential.
Look inside the cab. First of all, there's a lot of walnut, and you either like walnut or you don't like walnut, and that's up to you entirely. Personally, I find it a little bit dark. Having said that, the grey interior lightens it up, and it needs it. I think the fact that if you had a dark interior with the walnut, I think I'd feel a bit depressed, to be honest. But with the grey, we're lightened up. Actually, inside, when you look at it, it's a nice blend of traditional, if you like, the traditional side in terms of the walnut, and then you've got the technology side where the instrument panel, again, is all virtually all electronic. And also, interestingly enough, it's got this little reward system that helps the driver. If you're driving economically, then you get a little tick inside that says, hey, you're doing all right. And let's face it, when these trucks are doing 8, 9, 10 miles a gallon, if you're really lucky, and with fuel costs on a truck on average £100,000 per annum, then anything that can help the strapped driver and owner of the vehicle to save a little bit of money in terms of better fuel economy can only be a good thing.
The chassis on the XF has also been reworked to give better weight distribution and rigidity so that not one of the 510 horsepower goes to waste.
We're inside the Super Space cab, but this is the top of the range cab. And as you can see, you've got some great, you can actually stand up inside this cab. And this is meant for really being away maybe a week, doing runs from the UK down to Spain or Turkey or somewhere like that. So hey, this is a classic vehicle for the job. If you've got two people in here, you won't feel claustrophobic and you can stand up, get changed, and a really, really good cab for this sort of work. As far as driver's concerned and driving position, you've got steering wheel, everything's on there, multifunction steering wheel, in things like cruise control are available, and the seat itself, very comfortable. Not leather, just a cloth seat, but really comfortable, again, quite wide, and you've got the traditional armrest as well. At the side of me, right to my arm there, I've got the drive for the Acertronic gearbox, so everything falls to hand. It's really well set up for a driver, and very, very comfortable.
that's it for our look at the new DAF XF. I love the semi-wraparound dash, but also it's a nice blend of technology as well, and I'm sure it's going to be a great hit with many of its traditional customer base.